answer attached to my book. I'm sorry, Mom, but I did it for science.
I really believe in the power of water data. My startup is called Riverkin, and we basically build and deploy a large quantity of water quality sensors. And we do this not in the urban setting, but actually in more difficult and dynamic river systems. So that would be downstream of glaciers, upstream and downstream of hydropower plants, near agricultural sites. And then with our sensor ecosystems, we call them, we collect water quality parameters like temperature, flow, suspended sediments, and conductivity, and then we create different metrics for our clients. I do everything myself. Basically, from building the sensors, testing them, making sure everything is waterproof.
Oh my God. Oh. It's dry.
No, it's dry.
Do it, you fail, you learn, you get back up again, and you make a better one. Going into the field, taking my kayak sometimes to regions where I think that would be a really good location to install a sensor, but there isn't an easy way to get there. I get in the boat, I actually bring the hammer with me, I bring the rebar, I pick the location.
So I found a location in those bushes.
Here I have the sensor on, strapped with hose clamps. I measured the distance to the bottom, and now I'm gonna hammer it in with this giant piece of machinery.
And then I install them, and then I take them out again, I analyze the data, write papers, get a PhD, and now try to start a company. The Student Project House has been everything in helping me transition from a PhD into now the Pioneer Fellowship. I was the most coached project at the Student Project House last year. My hope is that we can make water data more accessible to way more people. We can really democratize water quality data. That's what I would really love to do.